Our scriptural text is from Luke 2, verse 45. It says, And when they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem seeking him. Many interesting stories have been written about the childhood of our Savior. We call most of them apocryphal stories, which means they are probably not true. Some of these tell about flowers springing up from the touch of his little hand, or how he caused the lost toys of his small friends to reappear. One account tells about the young Jesus molding clay birds, which then spread their wings and flew away. All little children do sweet and clever things. How strange and interesting that the only happening recorded in the Bible regarding Jesus as a child is that of his being lost at the Passover in Jerusalem. Of course, you know the story well, how Jesus, age 12, became so interested in listening and asking questions in the temple that he stayed on while his parents started for home. A whole day passed before Mary and Joseph realized that the child was actually not with the group. Panic-stricken at their carelessness, they hurried back to find him. The story ended happily when they were reunited with Jesus. As we understand it, the custom was for men and women to travel in separate groups, so it would have been logical for Mary to think that her son was with Joseph and for Joseph to think the child was with his mother. But why is this particular story recorded for us when Jesus must have done many things worth writing about during his early life? Could it be because it is so easy for us to lose Jesus that this event was written down? If his mother could lose him, how much more apt are we to be guilty of the same neglect? On the first day of that trip back to Nazareth, Joseph and Mary were so interested in visiting with their friends that they failed to realize that Jesus was not with them. There was certainly nothing wrong in talking with good friends. But in this case, what was good kept them from having what was the best in the whole world, the Lord Jesus. This same thing can happen so easily to us today. We accept something that's pretty good and thereby lose what is so much better. As was the case with Mary and Joseph, it will take longer to regain our relationship with Jesus than the few minutes it took to lose the divine presence. If we keep ourselves distracted from the cares and pleasures of this world and be ensnared by them, in just a blink, we will lose our Savior's presence. Let us therefore make our Lord Jesus the focal point of our lives. Thank you for listening, and be sure to join us again next week for our weekly devotional reading.